is an executive director at Vision India Foundation, New Delhi. He is the co-founder at Rashtram School of Public Leadership at Southwest Delhi. Previously, he has worked for Amazon.com in Seattle and served as the Joint National Organizing Secretary of Youth for Seva. Sir has completed B.Tech in Computer Science and Engineering, IIT Bombay, has completed MS in Computer Science and Engineering, University of Washington, Seattle, USA, has completed his MBA from Indian School of Business. Sir, we welcome you.
I now request our Honorable Vice Chancellor, Dr. Shivendra Gupta, to welcome Mr. Mathur with flowers. I request Dr. Gupta to felicitate Dr. Mathur with a memento. Thank you, sir. I request our Registrar Shri Hirnesh Kumar Bhausar to welcome our Honorable Vice Chancellor with flowers and a memento. Thank you, sir. I request Dr. Praveen Dudhagra, co-coordinator of the SSIP in the program today, to welcome Shri Hirnesh Kumar Bhausar with flowers and a memento. Thank you, sir. I request Dr. Aarti Rajaguru, SEC coordinator, for a welcome address.
Respected dignitaries on the dais, off the dais, respected guests, my dear members of Veer Narmad South Gujarat University family, respective representatives of media, and the most importantly, dear participants, my namaskar to all of you. I am very happy to welcome you in this gathering of young and enthusiastic entrepreneurs of the future. I am very glad to greet you all on this pleasant morning of September on our green and clean VNSU campus. Our university is privileged to host this one-day bootcamp on startup and innovation to promote New India entrepreneur. Our university has organized this kind of program for the first time since the existence of, or you can say the establishment of Startup and Entrepreneurship Council of Veer Narmad South Gujarat University. It has almost completed 3 years. As we all know that India is heading towards a brave new phase to world, and the future of India lies in the hands of youth like you people. We are very glad to guide young men and women for their new ventures through this activity, to provide you training and enhance your capacity and skills The whole program is designed in slots that will widen your vision for venture, and I'm sure that it will boost your determination and dedication for innovations. Today we have very renowned guests with us to guide you to be a successful entrepreneur. They are very experienced dignitaries in their respective fields of supporting and guiding new young innovators and entrepreneurs just like you people. All you have to do is take best benefit of their expertise and knowledge to convert your innovative ideas in and true innovation, and ultimately to convert it in a successful business. Just arise, awake, and stop not still the goal is achieved. At this point, I would like to mention something regarding the queries I received yesterday by some reporters or journalists, you can say. He was inquiring about whether how to register the startup, and is it correct that every registered startup will get 25 lakh rupees from the government, which he or she has not to return to the government? Well, many such queries are there in your minds, I know that, and I'm damn sure if you attend all the four sessions, then you will get correct answers to all those your queries. And please, I request you not to pass on any wrong message to the society. Once again, I am honored to welcome all of you and greet you on this beautiful morning to this program. Thank you all.
Thank you very much, madam, for that welcome address. Moving ahead in the function, I'm really very pleased to tell everyone in the conference hall that we have prepared a toolkit for the students, which would be giving students all the details about entrepreneurship and innovation. I would very earnestly request Dr. Shivendra Gupta, Honorable Vice Chancellor and the President of the function, to release that book. I also request all the dignitaries on the dais to join him in releasing that toolkit, which is meant for the students. It is an information book on students, innovation, and startups. Thank you, sir. Thank you, dignitaries. There's one more very significant announcement today, that this university doesn't just organize relevant functions, but is also initiates courses and programs in the direction. I'm really very happy to announce that the university is going to start a certificate course on startups and entrepreneurship. I would very earnestly request Dr. Rajesh Patel to come forward and give an introduction of the course.
Good morning, everybody.
As you could see, the course has been launched, and now Dr. Rajesh Patel will give us a detailed introduction about various nuances of the course.
It is a matter of very pleasure for me to introduce such kind of the innovative course for the entire VNSU society. This is an add-on course, a certificate course, which is designed with the 120 credits. And basically, this would be course which can be taken by any graduate student or the postgraduate student. Course will be running in a different schedule as per the need of the students. We'll be having the 4 unit. The first unit would be focusing about the innovation. And as we all know, that innovation is the mother of the startup today. So students have to learn from their basic studies that how to go for the innovation. You can recall a simple case of the Coca-Cola bottle opener design that was invented very long back by a simple people. And he has drawn that figure and he has kept as such. So that is an innovation that we can have. In the second module, we'll be talking about the intellectual property right. The design we had developed for the Coca-Cola opener that was not having any use at that time. But he has protected his design by the intellectual property right. And when the right time has came, he got the money from that. So that is the second phase, that during the study, student can nurture the idea, nurture the new innovations, and protect it with the IP. After getting the enough exposure, and if he is entering in the real world of the business, he can go in the 2 venture, either the startup and the entrepreneur. In the entire day session, you will have the details about that. But we should learn scientifically that how the startup can be initiated and how it can be managed. So remaining 2 units are designed in such a way that you will get the idea that how the government is supporting, how the entire ecosystem is developing, not only in the VNSU, but in the entire India to promote the startup and entrepreneurship. And nothing can be done with the blend of the management. So in the last unit, we'll be just focusing on the management skills specifically for the startup and the entrepreneurship. We'll be also having these small practical modules, which will be having the 2 credits. One module would be just taken for the field trip and the entire case study, and the remaining 2 would be for the soft skill for the management of the innovation and IP. And this entire program would be run on the physical basis for the first 2-3 years. After that, we'll be just converting the entire course in the MOOC. The entire program is launched on the Moodle website, and that can be accessed by the others also. So we are having the plan to run this course for a long term for a large number of the students of this university, and even if vice-chancellor permit for the others also for promoting the startup. So that are the details, and if you're having any further queries, you can contact us anytime. Thank you very much. And I hope that you'll be enjoying the session today, and even you'll be having any queries, we'll be happy to solve your queries. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Dr. Rajesh Patel, for that detailed introduction on the certificate course. May I now request Dr. Praveen Dudagra, co-coordinator, Student Startup and Innovation Policy, to come for a thematic introduction of the program.
Good morning to all. Honorable Vice Chancellor Dr. Savendra Gupta sir, chief guest of the today's function Dr. Sobhit Mathur sir, coordinator of the Student Entrepreneurship Council of the University Dr. Aarti Rajaguru, registrar of the university Dr. Harness Bausar sir. On the behalf of the SSIP cell, I warmly welcome all the dignitaries on the dais of the dais, invited guests, and all the young faces sitting in front of me. This hopeful morning, with the bright possibility of the student startup boosting themed program on bootcamp on startup and innovation to promote the new India entrepreneur. SSIP was established in the year 2018 with the able guidance of the Honorable Vice Chancellor of the University and other senior faculties as well as the administrators. Currently, SSIP is coordinated by Dr. Bharat Modi, Professor, Department of Physics, and I am the co-coordinator of the SSIP. Due to the unavoidable circumstances, Dr. Bharat Modi is absent today. So on the behalf of him, I am introducing the activity of the SSIP as well as the program of today. Today's program is jointly organized by the SEC and the SSIP of the university. The major objective of the SSIP is to convert the academic student mind to an entrepreneur one. We are putting our efforts on developing student-centric innovation, pre-incubation facility, and the student startup ecosystem for the student of the South Gujarat region. As you know that the South Gujarat region having a rich biodiversity and the natural resources, along with that, we have developed a close association with the modern industrial development in Surat, which is the well-known for the textile as well as the diamond industries. Apart from that, the Ankleswar, a part of the Golden Corridor, harboring the many small, medium, as well as the micro-scale pharma, agrochemical, as well as the chemical product industries. VNSU is serving since last 53 years for giving a valuable education service to the urban to tribal area of the university of the South Gujarat region. The university has been nurturing student and develop the developed to them to become an employee as well as the entrepreneur in the line of the Startup India as well as the Gujarat SSIP mission. Now we are geared to enrich regular academic attributes of the student with blend of the startup as well as the innovation to promote the new India entrepreneur zeal among the next generation. VNSG has already signed the MOU for the 5 year with Gujarat Knowledge Society, an implementation agency for the SSIP. As you know that the startup and entrepreneur are interchangeably used words, though the theme of the both the concept is to become self-employed basically. But technically speaking, the entrepreneur is one who organizes, manages, and assumes the risk of the business as well as the enterprise, while a startup is a young company founded by a one or more entrepreneur in order to develop a unique product or the service and bring it to the market. So the startup is the scalable operation which can convert the simple seed to the multi-branch banyan tree. So we have gathered at the VNSGU today to scale up the small thought of the startup from subconscious mind of our student as well as the faculty to break the common trend of our graduates and the postgraduates to rush for the employment. So in current world, the global business and the existing trade war condition, we Indian needs army of innovative entrepreneur to fight the battle of the knowledge supremacy. A boot camp is our humble effort to ignite our student as well as the faculty. So today's program is designed also in innovative way with the participatory learning module. We will be having a guidance of Mr. Shobhit Mathur from the Vision India Foundation, New Delhi. After the key address, Ms. Riya Motwani will enlighten on innovation, startup, as well as the MSME. And the second morning session on incubation processes of the startup will be illuminated by the Dr. Jay Kumar Joshi from the EDII Ahmedabad. After the lunch, the afternoon session will encompass the valuable talk on sources of the financial support for the startup as well as the innovation, which will be delivered by the Krupal Singh Dabi. And the second session will be on innovation, IPR, as well as the patent will be delivered by the Pancham Baraya from the GTU. So along with these technical informative sessions, we will try to gauge the entrepreneur characteristic with the self-assessment, and at the last, in the validatory session, out of the outstanding entrepreneur abled person, we will select the 3 boys as well as the 3 girls and will be given a prize as well as the certificates. So today's bootcamp is designed to look within and pull out our potential to a startup innovator. I hope you all will enjoy the session and be associated with us for the endeavors in futures. We are very thankful for the constant guidance and the inspiration from the Honorable Vice Chancellor, Dr. Sivendra Gupta, as well as the other staff from the university. I wish all the best to all the participants, hoping that at one day you will cross this boundary of the audience to expert. We heartily welcome the constant support from the colleges as well as the departmental faculty in these events, and also guarantee similar association as well as the support for such initiative program at their home institute. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Dr. Dudagra. A leader is one who knows the way, goes the way, and shows the way. Our university is fortunate to have such a leader amidst us, Dr. Shivendra Gupta. Sir, I request you to please come forward for the presidential address.
Dignitaries on the dais, dignitaries off the dais, my Veer Narmad University family, the participants, would-be entrepreneurs, members of the press, and anyone else present in this hall, I welcome you all. Entrepreneurship begins with necessity. Main iska ek example dena chahta hoon ki 50s mein, Raj Kapoor had become a big name as a film producer and as an actor. Sahil Ludhianvi was a poet, he was a shayar, and in one mushaira, Raj Kapoor encountered the presence of Sahil Ludhianvi and instantly offered him to write songs for his films. साहिर रिप्लाइड कि सर मैं स्वांते सुखाए लिखता हूँ, मैं बेचता नहीं हूँ अपने गीत, आप मुझे माफ़ करिएगा, मैं स्वांते सुखाए लिखता हूँ, बेचता नहीं हूँ। साहिर अनमैरिड रहे पूरी ज़िंदगी, उनकी मदर थी, वो बहुत बीमार पड़ी, उनको 500 रुपए की ज़रूरत पड़ी, तो उन्होंने राज कपूर को फ़ोन किया कि आपने एक बार मुझे ऑफ़र किया था कि मेरे गीत खरीद लेंगे, तो मैं आज बेचने के लिए तैयार हूँ, मुझे 500 रुपए की ज़रूरत है। तो राज कपूर ने कहा कि पहले अपनी माँ का इलाज कराओ, गीत हम ले लेंगे। तो साहिर ने पहला जो गीत लिखा फिल्मों में आने के बाद, उसकी पहली दो लाइन थी, आज उन गीतों को बाजार में ले आया हूँ, आज उन गीतों को बाजार में ले आया हूँ, मैंने जो गीत तेरे प्यार की खातिर लिखे, आज उन गीतों को बाजार में ले आया हूँ, मैंने जो गीत तेरे प्यार की खातिर लिखे। हम में से हर एक में कुछ ना कुछ टैलेंट है, स्किल है, वो स्किल को ही कन्वर्ट करना एंटरप्रेन्योरशिप में, यही एसेंस है। इस जो हम कर रहे हैं यहाँ पे, वो इसीलिए कर रहे हैं कि आपके अंदर जो स्किल है वो स्किल को हम आगे ला सकें, उसको प्रमोट कर सकें, फाइनेंशियल हेल्प दे सकें, जहाँ ज़रूरत है टेक्निकल सपोर्ट दे सकें, हम वायबल ऑल्टरनेटिव्स आपको बताएं कि आप कैसे आगे बढ़ सकते हैं। मैं जो मेरा रिटर्न एड्रेस है उसमें से भी थोड़ा सा पढ़ूंगा, वैसे मुझे रिटर्न पढ़ने की आदत है नहीं। I am pleased to know that the Student Startup and Innovation Policy SSIP and Startup and Entrepreneurship Council SEC Veer Narmad South Gujarat University are jointly organizing a one-day boot camp on startup and innovation to promote new India entrepreneur. Today, India has been a land of entrepreneurs. Indians were amongst the most advanced civilizations of the world, and the history of entrepreneurship in India can be dated back to the Harappan period, where it has been found that and proven that Indians traded in pottery, ornaments and animals with Iran and Turkmenistan. The Indus Valley Civilization organized trade at a time when the other parts of the world were nothing but barbaric tribes, 1000 BC to 500 BC, wherein the Indian trader brought silk from China and sold to Central Asia and bought horses from Central Asia and sold to China. The Maurya age was the golden age for India, which not only led to the unification of vast territories of the Indian subcontinent, but also made India the biggest exporter of highly valuable commodities. After that, during the Gupta age, India saw the organization of trade and commerce. The Middle Ages saw the invention of paper and the printing press. Construction of dams, roads, and infrastructure picked up the pace. The Europeans were attracted to India because of the vast wealth and trade superiority that India possessed at that time. मैं आपको यहाँ एक बताना चाहता हूँ कि एम्परर जहांगीर के टाइम में एक ब्रिटिश ट्रेवलर सर थॉमस रो आगरा आया, एंड ही वॉज अलाउड टू अटेंड दीवाने खास, देर वर टू ऑडियंसेज, दीवाने खास एंड दीवाने आम, जिसमें जहांगीर खुद बैठा और उसको बताया गया कि ये इंग्लैंड से आए हैं और क्वीन के प्रतिनिधि उन्होंने अपने आप को बताया, वो थे कि नहीं वो पता नहीं, लेकिन थॉमस रो ने कहा कि ही रिप्रेजेंट्स द क्वीन एंड ही वॉन्ट्स टू ट्रेड विद इंडिया on behalf of queen. In fact, in Diwane Khas aur Diwane Aam, keval emperor baithte the, baki sab khade rehte the. So Thomas Rowe thought that he was a dignitary and he asked Jahangir to provide him with a chair. And Jahangir was told by his advisors that he is asking for a chair to sit on and talk. Jahangir replied that, okay, he can ease himself against a pillar, but he cannot be provided a chair. लेटर ऑन सर थॉमस रो, जहांगीर ने उसके जो साइड में राइट हैंड साइड में एक पॉट रहता था जिसके अंदर जहांगीर ने अपना हाथ डाला एंड ही गेव नंबर ऑफ कॉइन्स. थॉमस रो हैज़ रिटन लेटर ऑन दैट देर वर 24 गोल्ड कॉइन्स दैट आई गॉट एंड दिस वॉज सफिशियंट फॉर 7 ऑफ माई जनरेशंस टू लिव वेल. ही हैड ए लार्ज पाम, जहांगीर हैड ए लार्ज पाम. देन जहांगीर आस्क्ड हिम व्हाट द क्वीन हैज सेंट मी. sent that gifts and all. So Thomas Rowe presented with some plastic toys and a horse. So Jahangiri started weeping. What happened? Thomas Rowe asked the translators, ki kyon ro rahe hain emperor? So unko bataya gaya ki he is very sorry that your queen is so poor that she cannot afford proper gifts to be given to an emperor. So Jahangir started weeping. So this was India. Even during medieval times, we had great wealth, and people came to India to trade with us, to live with us, to enjoy the hospitality of the Indians. That was India even during medieval period. Before that, it was even greater. The Indian entrepreneur retained his entrepreneurship zeal and spirit. We have examples such as Sir J. N. Tata, Ghanshyam Das Birla, Lala Shri Ram, Shri Badri Prasad Goenka, Jamnalal Bajaj, and some more, many of whom not only were visionary entrepreneurs, but also contributed immensely to our freedom movement. After the 1990s, when India opened its doors to the world through liberalization, privatization, and globalization, new age entrepreneurs like Ratan Tata, Narayan Murthy, M.S. Oberoi, Adi Godrej, Dhirubhai Ambani, Azim Premji, Uday Kotak, Anand Mahindra, etc., put India on the global landscape of world-class business led by traditional entrepreneurship. Here, when the age of technology dawned and the business started changing from traditional profit or sales-centric models to new age platform and digital models, it was the most natural thing for an Indian entrepreneur to evolve and rejuvenate himself as per the need of the day. Hence, now we see a slew of businesses in India which not only compete with an Amazon or a PayPal. Fortunately, we have our guest who has worked for Amazon for some time, but also collaborate with these world leaders in helping them improve their business models. Today, we have giant companies such as Flipkart, MobiKwik, Paytm, Ola Cabs, Make My Trip, Oyo Rooms, Zomato, which were once upon a time garage startups. Indian entrepreneurs have made their mark all across the globe, and 14 out of 250 odd unicorn companies with a valuation of more than 1 billion in the US have Indian founders. In the year 2018, India had more than 7,200 startups with an astonishing growth rate of 108%. According to NASSCOM, these companies created 40,000 direct jobs and a threefold increase in indirect employment. As a matter of fact, startup and innovation have been the key elements in the national policy of the Government of India, as well as the Government of Gujarat for a long time now. The incumbent government has been mobilizing all the possible resources to ensure that country leads the world in startups and innovations. Moreover, the government has been massively funding the initiatives which boost the innovations, startups, and entrepreneurship to develop a conducive ecosystem for an ambitious goal of accomplishing the 5 trillion economy at the earliest. As India, a nation, witnesses this phenomenal rate of growth in the startup industry, the university has decided to contribute by organizing the boot camp, thereby providing a platform to the students who wanted to make an attempt at entrepreneurship using the new business models. Hence, Veer Narmad South Gujarat University, in line with the initiatives of the Government of Gujarat, started the Startup and Entrepreneurship Council in September-October 2016 and organized its first seminar in March 2017 to create awareness and promote entrepreneurship among students. About 150 students participated in this one-day program. Two more such seminars were organized in July 2017 and January 2018 respectively. Under the aegis of the university, and the total of more than 400 students have been trained in entrepreneurship and formation of startups. Apart from this, the various departments of the university have been actively organizing guest lectures to motivate students for their own startups. We have been inviting experts from the industry who have their personal success stories to share with the students. Assignments related to startups and business initiatives have been incorporated as tools in the curriculum of most courses offered by the university. The university is trying very hard to create an atmosphere which is rich in innovative thinking and out-of-the-box business ideas. Today's boot camp is an endeavor in the same direction. We wish to give our students every opportunity at turning to be successful entrepreneurs who are capable of initiating new startups. Today we have with us stalwarts from the industry who shall enlighten and engage our participants with their experience and knowledge. I am sure today's interaction will boost the confidence of our students who want to try their hands at startups and new ventures. We have brought an amalgam of people from startup industry, experts from DIC, experienced faculty from leading entrepreneurship development organizations of the country, and facilitators who can also help students garner finance for their ventures. I sincerely hope and wish that today's camp will be a huge step forward in taking our students' spirit and enterprise to the next level. I wish you all the best and happy learning. Jai Hind, Jai Jai Garvi Gujarat. Now, I want to give one example of entrepreneurship, an innovative example. Do seth the, ek seth tirth yatra pe ja raha tha. Usne dusre ke ghar pe aake kaha ki bhai, mere ghar pe ghoda pada hai, tumko chahiye to 500 rupaye mein deta hu. To usne bola 500 rupaye mein kahan ghoda milega, bola ghar pe aake dekh lo. पहले तो बोला नहीं कोई बात नहीं मैंने खरीद लिया. उसने घोड़ा 500 रुपए दे दिए और वो तीर्थ यात्रा पे निकल गया. अगले दिन वो घोड़ा देखने गया तो घोड़ा मरा हुआ था. तो उसने कहा कि यार देखो उल्लू बना के चला गया, 500 रुपए में भी फालतू रहा ये, खैर कोई बात नहीं मुझे तो कुछ करना है. तो उसने क्या किया कि उसने लॉटरी निकाली, 10,000 टिकट बेचे एक एक रुपये में और कहा कि जो जीतेगा फर्स्ट आएगा उसको घोड़ा इनाम. तो जो फर्स्ट आया वो एक रुपए का टिकट लेके आया, भाई मेरा घोड़ा लाओ. तो उसको दे दिया घोड़ा मरा हुआ. तो बोले आप मरा हुआ घोड़ा दे रहे हैं यार, आप बात करते हो हैं. तो बोला क्या है, लाओ एक रुपया लाओ. एक रुपया वापस किया तुम्हारा, एक रुपए का टिकट वापस कर दिया. और उसको तो जब वो दूसरा आया तो उसने बोला उसको कुछ बात ही नहीं कर रहा है वो कि क्या एक्सपीरियंस हुआ. तो उसने कहा कि मैं तेरे को मरा हुआ घोड़ा दे के चला गया, तू कुछ बोल ही नहीं रहा है. तो बोला मैं क्या बोलूँ, मैंने तो 10,000 रुपये कमाए उस घोड़े से. मेरा मतलब ये नहीं कि ऐसा करने का, लेकिन मेरा मतलब यह है कि हर अपॉर्चुनिटी में आप एंटरप्रीनरशिप ढूंढ सकते हैं. यू कैन फाइंड समथिंग इन द वेस्ट ऑल्सो, वॉट वी कंसिडर एज वेस्ट यू कैन मेक ए कैपिटल आउट ऑफ इट. दैट इज वॉट आई वॉन्ट टू से. गॉड ब्लेस यू ऑल एंड हैव ए नाइस डे.
थैंक यू वेरी मच सर. एज यूजुअल इट वाज एनर्जेटिक, फुल ऑफ एनेक्डोट्स एंड एग्जांपल्स. As you rightly said, waste, somebody said, is a resource lying at a wrong place. If we know how to use that waste, we can convert it into enterprises. And there are hundreds of examples of that. Now, we are coming to much awaited keynote address. May I very earnestly request Dr. Shobhit Mathur, Executive Director, Vision India Foundation, Delhi, and the chief guest of the function today for the keynote address, please.
Thank you. Respected dignitaries on the stage, most particularly Dr. Shivendra Gupta, with whom I have had a great time so far in the past 1 hour. His lot of such stories and interesting anecdotes which have kept me engaged. And other dignitaries, Dr. Hinesh Kumar, Dr. Aarti, and Dr. Praveen, and all my dear young friends here. Thank you for inviting me to give the keynote address on this very important occasion. I think Gujarat has been a very fascinating state for a lot of us across the country. and I'm now coming from Delhi. So this, I mean, there's a lot of fascination about what is it in the Gujaratis who are running this country. Earlier it would just be known for the entrepreneurship and the business, right? But now also for the political acumen and the way they have been able to take a lot of bold decisions. So it's for me a great experience as well. And most importantly, this particular topic of encouraging young people to become entrepreneurs, I think there cannot be a more important topic than this in today's times. So let me start with a bit of background about myself, because I come from a state of Telangana, Hyderabad, right? Typical story, jaise aap log sab yahan par hai, if some of you are good in maths, you have chosen engineering. So aisa mera bhi tha. So school mein I did well in maths, to pitaji ne bola IIT ka entrance de do. So in 2000, I don't know if you have seen India at that, 20 years back, na? So wrote the IIT JEE entrance, 100 ke andar rank aa gaya. So we chose computer science, okay? Computer science, in whatever I would choose. So computer science, IIT Bombay was the top. So I chose kiya and I got it. So if you see the year 2000, I think not too many of you will know, but there was something called the big dot-com boom. Boom hua, and then a bust happened, right? Lot of the, startups in the US, huge valuations, and then in about a few years, all of them went bankrupt. So it was a very interesting time to choose computer science. So when I went to IIT the first day, our professor asked, kya karna chahte ho? So you should say startup banana hai, .com, wagera na. So then that was the kind of time where you didn't know. Matlab, internet had barely come to India. So email ID banana was a big thing, right? That is the time when I chose computer science. And then as we went about, and for some time, computer science all done, pehli bar computer se interaction wagera. So then a typical attitude at that time, matlab, if I see when I was graduating, startup, nobody, IIT Bombay, computer science, out of a batch of 50 graduating students, 48 graduating students, just one person thought of doing a startup. Because the economic situation of the country at that time was pretty much job seeking. Ki naukri lag gayi to badi baat hai, right? Nobody wouldn't think abhi IITs and other good institutions like where I am today are thinking of doing startups. At that time, startup ke baare mein soch bhi nahi the hum log. So this is a time where most of us would choose to do jobs, and I chose to study further. So I went to the University of Washington in Seattle. Now, Seattle, agar aap tab ke baare mein sochenge, to it is the headquarters of Microsoft, okay? And I had not even heard of a company called Amazon. Amazon ka bhi headquarters was Seattle. So particularly, Seattle was known for Microsoft. So I went, did my master's there. At that time, can you imagine? Just about 15 years back, Amazon was the startup, right? And I graduated and I chose to join Amazon. Amazon started in the year about 1996, and I joined it in 2006. Even 10 years later, it was not making money. Okay, so jaise main aap sabse baat kar raha hu, aise Jeff Bezos, who was the CEO and the founder, would move along all of us. Like it was just a 2000 low-key company thi, right? It was in downtown Seattle, and primarily it was known for selling books, right? That was the business, online e-commerce selling books. So Jeff Bezos used to be among us like this, and then he used to inspire, right? Ye karna hai, ye karna hai. And then hum sab log kaam pe lag jate the, and we should do a lot of work. I worked for Amazon for about 3.5 years, theek hai? Till that time, just Amazon was starting to transform from an e-commerce company into web services and an engineering company, right? It was also Kindle had started. Abhi unke pure jo web services hai, that just started during that time. So it was very interesting that a company is transforming itself, and behind the scenes, maximum hum log the. Lot of managers, engineers, computer scientists, all of these people were Indians. So if you see at that time, even now, the CEO of Microsoft is an Indian, the CEO of Google is an Indian. So hum log, we were working for a person called Jeff Bezos and helping him build his company. ठीक है. एंड अल्टीमेटली व्हाट इज अमेजॉन ऑल अबाउट? अमेजॉन इज ट्राइंग टू सेल यू मोर थिंग्स एट अ चीपर कॉस्ट. लाइक सिंपल राइट, इन टर्म्स ऑफ वन लाइन डिस्क्रिप्शन ऑफ अमेजॉन इज, और ज़्यादा लोगों को बहुत सारी चीज़ें बेचनी है कम दाम पे, राइट. तो वाई एम आई स्पेंडिंग माई टाइम डूइंग समथिंग फॉर समबडी एल्स और उसका जिनका मिशन ऐसा है? तो देन आई थॉट ऑफ दैट एंड आई केम बैक टू इंडिया एंड द जर्नी हैज़ बीन वेरी डिफरेंट. नाउ इफ यू लुक बैक एंड सी जेफ बेज़ोस, राइट, ही इज़ द वर्ल्ड्स रिचेस्ट मैन, राइट. इफ यू सी हिज नेट वर्थ 7 lakh crores, राइट, दैट इज़ द लास्ट टाइम आई चेक्ड. इफ द स्टॉक प्राइस गोज अप, इट गोज अप, राइट. तो 7 lakh crore एंड द वर्ल्ड्स रिचेस्ट मैन हैज़ बीन जेफ बेज़ोस एंड ही जस्ट स्टार्टेड फ्रॉम अ वेरी सिंपल स्टार्टअप अमेजॉन विच वॉज स्ट्रगलिंग टू सर्वाइव वैन आई वॉज वर्किंग देर. So it has been a great journey, right? When I saw nobody in India thinking about startups, going to US, studying there, working for a startup, and then who now, I have seen him, right? I have seen how he has grown and how he is now the world's richest man. It's a big story. And uske piche unka idea hai, right? All the engineering is done by people like us. So that shows that there is a lot of possibility ki hum bhi bahut kuch kar sakte hain. And I think the Vice Chancellor has very clearly said that it is not, it is just a very brief amount of time jahan par we have seen a small, a dip in this, right, when itna wealth tha. So I want to just go about and just tell a small story about what was the Indian economic model, what was our business model, why were we what we were, okay. So if I can have the presentation up, please. Is there a slides? Okay. So just, there is a lot of talk about Western business models. What was the Indian business model? Because here I have heard that a lot of you are in the final year of undergraduation or post-graduation. So this was the world share of GDP. I think we can read a chart. Right? Niche, if you see, it is the x-axis is the number of years. Right? It is of course thoda distorted because 2000 saal ki history hai. Angus Madison naam ke ek economist ne iska research kiya tha ki world share of GDP kya hai. Right? तो भारत को मैंने ऑरेंज में रखा है. यू कैन सी इफ यू से स्टार्टिंग फ्रॉम 1 CE, राइट, 30% प्लस वॉज इंडियाज शेयर ऑफ ग्लोबल GDP, राइट. इट वॉज लीडिंग टिल अबाउट 1700, और यहाँ पर जैसे कि शिवेंद्र जी ने बताया, राइट, दैट इज वेयर यू सी द बिग डिप हैपनिंग. तो इफ यू सी इंडिया एंड चाइना इन ऑरेंज एंड रेड, वी वेयर लीडिंग द वर्ल्ड टिल अबाउट जस्ट 300 ईयर्स बैक, राइट. द वर्ल्ड हाइएस्ट शेयर ऑफ GDP वॉज अस. You see a big dip and then you see even China dipping, but China has recently risen a lot, right? So we are still struggling while they have risen up and now they are now going to compete with the rest of the world. So what is the reason for this 300 years mein itna bada dip? While 1700 years, aur uske pehle le jayenge to aur bhi zyada rahega, we were the world leaders. We were having the maximum share of the world's GDP in India. इसके ऊपर स्टडी नहीं किया है एंड लॉट ऑफ इट इज एंटरप्रेन्योरशिप, राइट. यू विल नॉट सी कि लोग सरकार की नौकरी, बिकॉज देयर इज नो बिग सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट या स्टेट गवर्नमेंट जो नौकरी दे रहा है एंड लोग नौकरी कर रहे हैं. इट इज बिल्ट ऑन एंटरप्रेन्योरशिप. आई थिंक दिस इज वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. ये डिप बहुत टेम्पररी रहा है. कैन वी राइज अप अगेन? एंड आई थिंक आज का सेशन या सत्र विल बी द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट. इफ इस ऑडियंस में से बाय द एंड ऑफ द डे they said there'll be some prize money and all these things, or I mean the prizes will be given, but if we can produce entrepreneurs, that is the way to come out, and I'll talk a little more about it if we can go next. Yeah, so ek kitab hai, The Beautiful Tree, Dharampal ji ne likha hai. So he was a person who went to the British records London mein, aur unhone study kiya ki kya tha India ka economic model, and it's very very relevant, particularly because of yesterday's news also. I'll tell you why. क्योंकि बिफोर द ईस्ट इंडिया कंपनी केम टू इंडिया एंड आफ्टर द ईस्ट इंडिया केम टू, इट्स काइंड ऑफ अ टैक्सेशन रेट के बारे में बता रहे हैं, राइट. सो अबाउट 75% ऑफ इट, ऑफ द प्रोडक्शन, वॉज लेफ्ट विद द पीपल हु प्रोड्यूस इट. तो एंटरप्रेन्योर या जो फार्मर या जो भी जो करेगा, राइट, रेस्ट ऑफ इट वॉज डिस्ट्रीब्यूटेड बिटवीन लोकल इंस्टीट्यूशंस. ओनली 5% वुड गो टू द सेंट्रल अथॉरिटी, राइट. इफ यू कैन से कि जैसे कोई राजा रह गए, एवरीथिंग वॉज लोकल. सो low taxation wala model, right? And then if you see after the East India Company, almost 60% would go to the central government and only 35% would stay with the actual producer. So 65% was taxed. Isliye to movie Lagan jo yahi isi state mein bani hai, right? Taxation is such a big thing. Just by changing taxation, right, how you can destroy an economy. And if you see yesterday's whole thing about reducing the corporate tax, 30% say 22%, it's so very, very important. How you can generate entrepreneurship and business and investment by the right taxation is as simple as that. And how India from being industrialized, agar aap log ne suna hoga ki almost every district of the country, particularly even UP ke bare mein ye bolte hain, har district ki ek speciality rahi hai. Jaise ki sir Agra se hai to leather, right? Meerut se hai to sports. So every district of the country was a specialist in a particular product, and it was globally marketed, global level par, not India level par, globally best, every district of the country, right? ऐसा कैसा, और उसको पूरा डी इंडस्ट्रियलाइजेशन बोलते हैं ना, हाउ इन जस्ट 200-300 ईयर्स द एंटायर कंट्री वॉज डी इंडस्ट्रियलाइज्ड जस्ट बाई सिंपल चेंजिंग ऑफ टैक्सेशन एंड कंट्रोल ओवर इंस्टीट्यूशंस. गो नेक्स्ट. बट नाउ टाइम इज चेंजिंग अगेन, राइट? अगर हम फॉरवर्ड करेंगे 300 साल और अभी देखेंगे तो क्या हो रहा है, राइट? दिस इज द लेटेस्ट 2008 की रैंकिंग ऑफ द वर्ल्ड जीडीपी, राइट? वी हैव बीटन यूके एंड फ्रांस वेरी रिसेंटली, राइट? एंड देन वेरी सून अगर हम इसको परचेसिंग पावर पैरिटीज वन कॉन्सेप्ट इन इकोनॉमिक्स इफ यू सी, देयर इज अ प्रेडिक्शन दैट इट विल बी चाइना इंडिया इन अबाउट 2050, राइट? सो वी विल बी राइजिंग अगेन. जो आपने चार्ट देखा ना, जो चाइना एंड इंडिया वेयर लीडिंग द वर्ल्ड फॉर 1700 ईयर्स, चाइना हैज रिजन अगेन. तो इट इज टाइम एंड द प्रेडिक्शन बाई एवरीबडी इज दैट वी विल राइज अगेन एंड वील अगेन बी द वर्ल्ड लीडर्स. सो दैट इज द गुड थिंग ऑन आर साइड, एंड कैन वी गो बैक एंड ऑक्यूपाई दैट पोजिशन इज वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. विल गो नेक्स्ट. तो इसमें पीछे क्या था, नेक्स्ट. या सो वॉट वॉज द इंडियन इकोनॉमिक मॉडल, इसके ऊपर स्टडी करना बहुत जरूरी है. एंड बिकॉज ऑल ऑफ यू आर स्टूडेंट्स इन दिस यूनिवर्सिटी, आई वुड एनकरेज यू टू थिंक अबाउट दिस. करेंटली अगर हम सोचेंगे तो बिग बिजनेसेस और द इकोनॉमिक्स इज ऑल डिटरमिंड बाय वेस्टर्न कॉन्सेप्ट्स. तो अपना इकोनॉमिक मॉडल क्या था, इसके ऊपर आई जस्ट वांट टू क्विकली गो थ्रू. विल गो नेक्स्ट. राइट, फैमिली एज अ बेस, जो शिवेंद्र जी ने बताया, ऑल द बिग businesses today are also family businesses. If you talk the Tatas, the Birlas, the Bajaj, right, the Godrej, family is a unit. Aaj bhi apne desh mein individual as a unit nahi sochte, family income kya hai iske bare mein sochte. It's a very different concept from the west. Family business ka model west mein hai nahi, right? They don't think about family businesses. But hamare yahan family ko as a unit sochte hain, as an individual ka wealth nahi dekhte hain. फैमिली एज अ यूनिट है, विद वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट कॉन्सेप्ट. और फैमिली जैसे जैसे जॉइंट फैमिली से, न्यूक्लियर फैमिली से इंडिविजुअल्स बन रहे हैं, वैसे वैसे अपना इकोनॉमिक मॉडल भी वीक हो रहा है. आई विल कम टू दैट कि क्यों हो रहा है ऐसा. नेक्स्ट, हाई सेविंग्स, 30% ऑफ वॉट वी अर्न इज टिपिकली सेव्ड. आपने घर पर देखा होगा, टिपिकली अपने फैमिलीज में सेविंग्स को बहुत महत्व दिया गया है, राइट? वाइल इफ यू लुक एट द वेस्ट, इट इज कंप्लीटली ड्रिवन बाय क्रेडिट, राइट? डेट ड्रिवन है. लाइक ओवरऑल डेट ऑफ US, आई थिंक इट हैज हिट $20 trillion, राइट? इफ यू थिंक अबाउट द हाउस होल्ड डेट, डेट इज वेरी हाई. पीपल लिव ऑन क्रेडिट कार्ड्स. यहाँ पर आपके घर पर आपने देखा होगा, राइट? टिपिकली आप पहली कमाई हो, जैसे भी हो, सेव करना है. सेविंग्स कैन जनरेट, बिकॉज सेविंग्स कैन बी इन्वेस्टेड, राइट? तो सेविंग्स आर वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. सो 30% ऑफ वॉट वी अर्न वी सेव. वी सेव नॉट जस्ट इन कैश. We are the world's largest consumers of gold. 24,000 tons of gold is privately owned. 24,000 ton gold is privately owned. Usko hum savings jaise nahi mante in modern economics. But that is also a type of saving, because aapne dekha hoga how wealth is transferred, right? The mother gives it to the daughter when she is getting married, right? Batwara hota hai, to how gold is distributed. So how gold is a way of saving. It's a very different concept. Ye modern economics mein gold is seen as just like a jewelry or an ornamental thing. But it is also a form of wealth. And historically it has been. Jab sir ne bataya ki Jahangir ne gold coins diye, right? Ab kabhi bhi dekho, history mein rewind karke dekho, gold has been seen as a form of money. Even today in our mind, gold is a form of money. But economics doesn't consider it as a form of money, right? That we have lost the importance of that. So that has traditionally been a form of saving in our country, or both unique hai. These models are very unique. You'll not find them anywhere in the West. You'll not find household owning of gold in the West. It is very unique to our country. Next, right? Self-employment is the base. Even today, it is said that 53% to is official statistics hai. 53% of the country is self-employed. People say it's beyond 90% also in some ways. People of India are not job seekers. They are not looking for white collar jobs, blue collar jobs. I think formal economy mein still it's about just 10-15% of the country which is formally employed, jinko at the end of the month ek paycheck aata hai, right? Formally ek job hai aur paycheck hai. Most of India is self-employed. Matlab entrepreneurship is there everywhere. This is what is said, right? Kisi ne say, matlab in jokes we say, right? Ki if you have already gone, right, if the Mount Everest, you will find some Indian entrepreneur there selling something, right? Because that is where, wherever there is an opportunity, people have seen of creating a business out of it. So India ke zehen mein hai, it's in our DNA, in the character to do self-employment, right? So, but somehow I see that in recent times, job seeking has become a very, right, thing. Hum log sab, we want to be job seekers, right? Not job creators. But traditionally, India has been self-employed. Right, 30% of the contribution to the GDP is by self-employed people. Right, they are all the small thela wala se leke, restaurant owner se leke, right? Anybody who's probably doing a boat ride, right? Kahin par to, they're all people who take credit and then start their own business. We'll go next. Community as social capital. This is very, very important. So far, matlab ek bahut controversial cheez hai, if I tell it this way, ki we have seen jati as something bad. Right? Jati is seen as something bad. Jati vaad is bad. But jati itself is not bad. Kyunki har jati ka traditionally ek specialization raha hai. Right? Abhi yahan par aane ke pehle, I was just discussing with some of my friends jinhone invite kiya. To for example, even in Gujarat, if you see, right? Even main abhi yahin pe jab campus mein ghoom raha tha, to Departmental of Journalism ke saamne koi resham wala ji ka naam likha tha. So I'm pretty sure ki unka traditional family business would have been silk textiles, right? Kisi ne mujhe bataya ki zari wala, right? Ek very popular sir. I'm taking Gujarati surnames. To jo unka family traditional specialization raha hai, unse unki identity bani hai. To jati is also social capital bolte hain, right? Kyunki unka traditionally usi family mein born hone se, aapke parents se, aapke ancestors se jo specialization seekha hai. If you are making the best textile in the world, right, Surat mein, naturally, jo agli pidi paida hogi, they will learn it from their parents and they will continue that. So, community as a strong social capital is very, very important. Especially, community financing bolte hain. Like, for example, ek bada joke hai na, Marwadis desh bhar mein phele hue hain, jahan par bhi jaate business shuru kar dete hain aur local business. Why are Marwadis so good at business? Unme kya hai? Because the credit given to them is verbal, right? It is all verbal agreements. Phone kiya, itna paisa yahan bhej do, le liya, kabhi aur wapas kar diya, right? It is all running on trust. Ek community hai, agar wo community ka aadmi kahin aur milta hai, to aapas mein trust immediately build up ho jata hai. Ye sabhi communities ke liye true hai. To community financing bolte hain. Aap bank ke paas jaoge, to aapko 10 document dene hain. Aapko proof karna padega ki main loan lautaunga, ye wo. बट आपकी कम्युनिटी के पास जाओगे तो आपको इजीली क्रेडिट मिल जाएगा एट अ मच लेसर रेट एंड विद लॉट ऑफ ट्रस्ट. तो बिजनेसेस विल सपोर्ट अदर बिजनेसेस, राइट? आपके जो परिवार के लोग हैं या लार्जर कम्युनिटी के लोग हैं, आपको सपोर्ट करेंगे बिजनेस चालू करने में. दिस इज वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. ऐसा फाइनेंसिंग मॉडल दुनिया में नहीं है. टिपिकली जितना फॉर्मलाइज हो रहा है इकोनॉमी, जितना फॉर्मलाइज इकोनॉमी हो रहा है, उतना मिस्ट्रस्ट बढ़ रहा है. क्योंकि आप किसी और शहर में जाओगे, आप बैंक लोन के लिए अप्लाई करोगे, आपको 10 डॉक्यूमेंट देने होंगे, इंटरेस्ट रेट 10-12% रहेगा, राइट? उतनी ही दिक्कतें रहेंगी. बट जितना कम्युनिटी के आसपास फाइनेंसिंग मॉडल रहेगा, इंटरेस्ट रेट्स कम रहेंगे, इजियर रहेगा क्रेडिट लेना, रिटर्न करना, बिजनेस सेटअप करना, शेयर होगा. तो कम्युनिटी, सपोर्टिंग कम्युनिटी इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर बिजनेस टू ग्रो. ठीक है, वी विल गो नेक्स्ट. राइट, सोसाइटी ड्रिवन, नॉट स्टेट डिपेंडेंट. अनफॉर्चुनेटली आज क्या हो रहा है, फॉर एवरी स्मॉल थिंग हम स्टेट से सब्सिडी मांगने की कोशिश कर रहे हैं. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, इवन इन द स्टार्टअप इंडिया प्लान बहुत बढ़िया है, बट वी आर वेटिंग फॉर द गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया टू सब्सिडाइज, गिव अस अ लोन, गिव अस टैक्स ब्रेक्स. बट ट्रेडिशनली इंडिया में इट हैज ऑलवेज बीन कम्युनिटी ड्रिवन, इट हैज नॉट बीन डिपेंडेंट ऑन स्टेट. कोई ऐसा बड़ा सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट नहीं था फॉर द बिजनेसिस इन इंडिया टू फ्लरिश, राइट? इट वॉज. So we can we change our mindset? Can we go beyond just thinking कि सरकार से क्या सब्सिडी मिलेगी, क्या लोन मिलेगी, क्या योजना मिलेगी जिससे कि कुछ होगा? क्योंकि ultimately जब तक आपका product में खुद, right, it is not adding value, right, the product will not run. Subsidy funding वगैरह से कुछ time चल जाएगा, but ultimately